having one in February, just to make sure that we hem in everybody so that we are all aligned in the same direction. I want to tell you that many, many ministers, many PSS are now on the rhythm. They now understand where we want to go. And going back to what my sister said.
Grace.
Grace. What Grace said. There is all that around, because the economy is difficult. So you will find people saying this must be the man who is causing problems. We have a problem with the energy. Then it is easy to blame the minister. But let me say a broader thing, you know, in this context, that to be able to move forward as a country, there are three important things that we must do. Number one, we must control debt. Number two, we must control expenditure. And number three, we must find revenue. You know, we must find revenue. Yes, I have gone out of my way, and I think we have a hold, we have a handle on debt. Mm-hmm. We're managing debt. Many Kenyans today are paying taxes. I am making sure that through digitization, we manage to collect as much as possible and it is not lost. I know it is painful on some on Kenyans that they've had to pay more. But this is temporary and, you know, this is work in progress. We are going to see how to improve that. The third most important thing, which is important to me, is how we control expenditure. Apart from cutting down on excesses, we also need to look at opportunities. You know, do you know that we have 287 agencies of government, parastatals and companies? 287. How much do I spend on these agencies every year? 250 billion. Yeah? If I could save 50, 60, 70 billion from these organizations, I would do a lot more, and I would not be pushing more people in the tax direction. And that is why we changed the law to facilitate privatization, to facilitate strategic investment, to facilitate merger of some companies, and to facilitate closure of some. Let me give you an example, because many people have been asking, so why does the government want to sell, you know, this company and this company and this company and this company? You know, taxpayers' money is being used to support many of these companies. Let me give you an example. I know many people are very sentimental about KICC. We said we want to privatize KICC. Let me explain to the people of Kenya. KICC is an iconic building. Mm-hmm. It is the center of the city. Mm. All of us, including myself. When I came first to Nairobi, I came to that photograph place where we are holding KICC at the top. And that will continue. People will continue taking photographs at KICC. But that's not why KICC was not built. That's why KICC, that was not why KICC was built. It was not built for photographs. It was built as a national asset. Mm-hmm. Let me tell the people of Kenya, KICC today is valued at 30 billion, right? How much money do we get from KICC? Last year we got 29 million. The other year we got, I think, 40 million. How much? 40 million. What a waste, you know? Because it is being managed inefficiently. I had to put 1.8 billion shillings to make it usable for Africa Climate Summit. Just imagine. So what I'm saying is, instead of having KICC as an office block, you know, the whole of that KICC there has offices of this person and that person, they are paying nothing.
Right.
Yeah? Why don't we transform KICC for it to become the international conference center that it was built to be.
Right.
Right?
So
just wait, the International Conference Center. And you know how much money we should be making from KICC if it is worth 30 billion? Mm. Even nominally, we should be getting 3 billion shillings a year. How much are we getting? We are not getting 3 billion. We are getting 29 million.
But Mr. President...
This is an asset of Kenya.
Mr. President...
This is a property of the
That question about privatization of KICC, for instance, of course, there's work that has to be done, public participation, people give their views, and
correct.
Eventually the decision is made. So is the intention to sell it all, or is it a portion of
the
it?
The intention is to commercialize. The intention is to have a mechanism, a strategic investor, so that we need to make it a true conference facility. And if we make it a truly conference facility, it will give us more than 3 billion shillings a year. Today, we are getting 29 million. If you ask any ordinary Kenyan, would we rather continue getting 29 million, would we do a strategic investment that would give us 3 or 4 or 5?
Kwa hivyo kumaanisha, Mheshimiwa Rais, changamoto inayoikumba KICC imepita ufahamu wa kuweza kwa serikali kuweza kuihakikisha kwamba inapata kile inachofaa kupata mpaka mnakwenda katika mkondo wa kuiprivatize.
Good question, my dear sister. KICC was not built yesterday. It's been there all these years. It has not happened in all the governments that came before me. Right? And this is why I am proposing what I am proposing, so that we have a different... Okay. Exactly answering your question. Wale hawakufanya, mimi nataka kufanya. I want to change KICC so that it makes money. Give me a chance
to
change KICC so that it makes money.
I want us to
let me conclude by saying,
yes.
Because our international conference center at KICC is not working, it has no capacity to host. If you go there, if I didn't invest 1.8 billion, nobody wants to have a meeting in KICC because it is dark. It has no facility, it has no what, it is no toilets, nothing. So, what has happened as a result of underperformance of KICC? Do you know that Intercont Hotel is closed?
Yeah.
Do you know that Hilton Hotel is closed? Do you know that Crown Plaza is closed? Do you know that all these other hotels are struggling? Because we have no international conference facility. Conference facilities are the ones that support our tourism sector, our convention sector, our hotel industry. We not only want to invest or get a strategic investor for KICC, I am also going to get a strategic investor for Bomas of Kenya. We need to build another conference facility in Kenya, in Bomas of Kenya, and we need to build maybe 2-3 hotels in Bomas of Kenya. It is what is going to change the fortunes of our country, especially the space around tourism.
Right.
So let me persuade the people of Kenya, right? KICC is not being sold to anybody. KICC is not being taken anywhere. KICC will remain there. Those who want to take photographs, you can continue taking photographs. But for heaven's sake, allow me to get a strategic investor, and I am not going to do it at night. In fact, many people have been saying maybe we change the law to make it easy for government property to be disposed. That's not true. The reason why the former law was changed is because since 2005, when it was implemented, we have not privatized a single thing because it was convoluted and it never went anywhere. Let me give you...
Mr. President.
Benefits. Allow me, because you know, this is a very important thing to me.
Yes,
so,
that.
This is... So when we said... We want to commercialize KICC. There are companies, Grace. There are companies like Postbank. Every morning when we open Postbank, we lose 3 million. In the last 5 years, we have lost 1 billion shillings every year. How much? 1 billion shillings every year. Because nobody wants to make a decision about Postbank. I want to make a decision about Postbank. I want to get the employees who are working in Postbank. I want to second them to other institutions. We close down Postbank. We stop losing a billion shillings. We stop losing a billion shillings every year. And we do something with a fund that is there instead of taking money from the fund and spending it. And you know, we are just being not prudent at all. Let me give you another example. Because, you know, this is what I want to do. This is what we are talking about. When we talk about privatization, we are not talking about just sale. We are talking about 4 or 5 aspects. There are places that will be leased. There are others that you will get strategic investors. There are others that you will get that you will take to the stock exchange. Let me give you another example. Kenya Pipeline Company. Kenya Pipeline Company is a company that is worth 300 billion Kenya shillings. How much?
300 billion.
300 billion. How much money are the people of Kenya getting from Kenya Pipeline? I think it is only once or twice that we have gotten 1 billion a year. Otherwise, we get 200 million, we get 300 million. This company, Kenya Pipeline, should be giving the people of Kenya 30 billion shillings every year.
So is it mismanagement or?
No, it is just strategic thinking that is not there. And that is what I want to do. Okay. It is just strategic thinking.
What's so KCC?
I'll come back there. What we need to do is, you know, there are people with still that mentality, Mali ya serikali si mali ya mutu. No. Mali ya serikali is our collective property, and it has to be managed well. And I have a responsibility to the people of Kenya that it is managed well, and I intend to manage it well. What have I done? I have changed policy. I brought the policy, because it is in my manifesto, I brought policy to cabinet. We said we need to change what we call government-owned enterprise policy, ownership policy. As an owner, every shareholder demands money for their shares. We are the shareholders. We demand money from the companies that are owned by government. So what do we need to do, for example, in Kenya Pipeline?
Right.
Kenya Pipeline, there is nothing strategic about Kenya Pipeline. This is just a transporter or fuel. That's all. It's a matatu for fuel. So what do we need to do? First, I have told them this year, they must give us a dividend of 5 billion this year. And they're going to give it. Because I have told them, you have to stop all these shenanigans. This is public asset. We cannot be taxing Kenyans when there is an asset here that should be giving us
money. How do you arrive at that target?
Of?
5 billion.
It is the initial money, but they should be, it should actually be 30 billion every year, because any economist will tell you, if your asset is this much, 10%, because if we were to sell Kenya Pipeline at 300 billion, we would get 300 billion, put it in a fixed deposit, we earn 30 billion every year. And yet we have the money sitting inside there.
Okay.
So let me conclude by saying this. And I'm sorry, you know, I have to explain to the people of Kenya some of the things that are being, you know, misconstrued to mean that we are not being prudent. I brought policy and I said, we are going to make sure that every government asset gives money to the shareholder, the government of Kenya, so that we look for additional revenue, because we cannot borrow. We have pushed Kenya enough on taxes. The only other way to raise money is to sweat our assets. Yeah? Is to sweat our assets. We must get our assets to pay us dividends. That's why, for example, Kenya Power, we have removed 4 directors that I appointed into the board to allow the private sector to appoint directors, because we want it to be run with the private sector support, right, because we value what the private sector has to say. Let me conclude by saying the following. Why is this in the right direction? Let me answer what this good man has said.